Uncle Ben examined the unusually warm stone for some time. Intrigued as he was, additional stones with strange properties would be required. If any more appeared, they were to be brought to him immediately, for a machine of great importance could be fashioned from them. Each time Kevin dabbed his mother's forehead with a wet cloth, he could feel her breath coming a little easier. He would do it forever if he knew it would make her well. The beauty of the ancient ruins was still evident through the decay brought on by time and sand. But once humble living quarters were now slums, the muck of the corruption.
Thank you.
detached from the object in the center of the room. In contending with the bandits, Adam and his group encountered the black substance again. John thought he heard his mother's voice calling, "Wake up, John. Wake up." Cold unpleasantness, ominous and dark, oozed beneath the doors and seeped through the cracks. Feeding the shy fish always involved much pomp and circumstance, a ritual that was usually held by Lucy and Linda and featured the animal's playfulness. She just wanted to survive until her child was born, as if her own life was not compared to the future that she carried within her. And from her husband, she just wanted a way to save Hope. Hope, the name she had picked for their child. Burn, burn away, leave us be. Lucy's fury flowed from both her hands and her tongue.
The black thing, unmoved, symbolized the grim resolve of a dark being.
Mark shivered as he looked upon the seemingly indestructible sacrificial altar that had come for his unborn sibling.
Ha! Huh.